song in a tuning like that. In dadgad tuning is the ability to just to improvise a little bit. That little instrumental section, that's really a jam song the Dead played very long versions of. So having all those open strings available allowed me to just kind of set strings ringing and then add some, experiment with some single string sort of soloing stuff, which is a lot of fun to play around with. Another tune that I wanted to do, but maybe open this up for questions. Anybody have questions before that?
Yeah.
Earlier, when you had that open G with a drop C tuning, that was even before that, was that a G11 chord that you were opening up on? Was there an A in there someplace?
Asking about the Stevie Wonder song, right? The higher ground with the C and G in the bass? It's a different song?
It was a different song.
Maybe afterwards we can figure it, zero in on which thing you mean. I'm not sure offhand. Sometimes in tunings, hit chords that sound good and have no idea what they're called. And I can sit down and figure it out, but sometimes it's nice not to even know. In fact, David Wilcox, any of you who know David Wilcox, a great singer-songwriter, guitar player, told me that he would like to have a sort of a curtain up so that, like, if he was listening to somebody play, he would like to just never know what their hands are doing. To like prefer the mystery of not knowing what chord he's playing, not knowing what other chords are playing, so that not thinking about it. But anyway, yeah, we'll figure it out. Anybody have other questions? Songs or anything?
Yeah, one more. You said a dadgad. You mean D-A-D-G-A-D?
D-A-D-G-A-D tuning, yeah. Which gets used in a lot of, it's kind of almost a standard tuning in a lot of Celtic music, Irish music. A lot of fingerstyle instrumental players play in dadgad tons. Pierre Bensuzan, the French guitarist, plays pretty much exclusively in dadgad tuning. It's kind of a, it's an interesting one that just puts you in a different kind of a modal zone on the guitar, I guess. Yeah.
This is sort of basic, but do you know how many octaves you can actually tune a guitar, like piano octaves? Do you know? Can you?
How many octaves on the guitar just in standard tuning, or?
Yeah.
Or can you?
Just like, I'm just totally guitar illiterate, so you've been talking about all these other kinds of tuning, but if somebody just starting out, and in terms of how many, in whatever the basic tuning kind of thing is, how many octaves on a piano will it, can you cover?
Four.
About three and a half.
Four octaves. Three and a half?
Three and a half.
Yeah.
Three and a half.
Okay. A lot of people would just make their whole careers playing in one, but they are there. I mean, the thing that's so unusual about the guitar is that any given note you can play in a number of different places on the neck too. That, unlike a piano, you know, you can't play two different piano keys and get the same note. But on a guitar you can. You can play a note, you know, I can play this D here, or I can play it on the second string, or I can play it here on the third string, or I can play it here on the fourth string, etc. So it gives a lot of options up the neck to explore if you want to explore it.
Are all the sharps and flats there as well?
Mm-hmm. Okay. The sharps and flats are there as well, yes.
And a strumstick.
any other questions before we do the last tune here? I shouldn't have changed those strings right before this came through.